Friends, Erica here, back with day 18 of the 31 Days of Spooky Scraps. Today's prompt is monochromatic, and I have two lovely guests with me today, Stacey White and Patricia Flores, so please be sure to check out their takes in the links below. Today, I'll be making a 12 by 12 mixed media page, and instead of going with the black and white typical monochromatic, I'm going warmer and sticking with warmer whites, tans, beiges, and golds. I have these cute little pumpkins that I just found an image of on Google and cut them out with my Cricut, as well as larger versions later in that beige paper over to the left. Now I'm taking some matte gel medium and creating three different textures on my pumpkins. A brush stroke, a bit of a crinkle effect here with some plastic wrap, as well as some drip trace marks, some trails, I think. So once that is all dried, after I use my heat gun, I am just mounting my smaller pumpkins on top of my larger pumpkins. Unfortunately, I'm still having some runner issues, but that's okay. Now I'm taking some Vicky Booten Gold Glaze, which I do go back and end up coloring the tan paper stem too, just because it looked a little better. This isn't a true gold, it's more of a burnished gold, but I still thought it was really pretty. Now to add a little bit of interest, I am putting everything on a tilt. And this is probably the most difficult part of the page because for some reason I have still not bought a ruler that's longer than 9 inches, and I should, because it would have made this a lot easier, but that's okay. So now I'm just trimming off the excess pumpkins, and I'm trying not to cut too much into them because they will actually be helping me repeat the patterns wherever the gaps are. So now I'm just erasing the lines that I marked to make sure that I stayed on a straight line, and now we'll be taking those pumpkin pieces and just placing them where I think that there are the largest gaps. Once I have that set, I'm just trimming the rest of that excess and I'm good to go. So now I will be backing my photo with this warmer white paper just to help it become a little bit more cohesive with my page. And I will be rounding the corners so it will blend in a little bit better with the roundness of my pumpkins. After that, I have located the alpha set from Felicity Jane I will be using. So I did, as you can see right there, there's the scallop edge that Felicity Jane is known for. I just kind of tore it off and put it underneath because, I mean, the trash wasn't going to use it, right? So now I have that alpha here, sans scallop bottom, and I go with family because the theme and then also the space available. And finishing off with some Nouveau hearts. I did end up going back and spackling that gold glaze onto my title family, and it looked a lot better. So I'm really glad that I did that because it was probably going to bug me in the end. But that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed watching. Thank you so much for joining me. Please leave me a comment, say hello. I'd love to hear from you, and I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day. See you next time. Bye.